mission station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground, your weekly look at what's happening on board the International Space Station. I'm Amika Cowder. With the first spacewalk of Expedition 41 less than a week away, flight engineers Barry Wilmore, Reid Wiseman, and Alexander Gerst readied equipment, tools, and of course their spacesuits in preparation for the two U.S. extravehicular activities scheduled this month. Wiseman and Gerst are set to venture outside the orbiting complex on Tuesday, October 7, at 8:10 a.m. Eastern for a 6.5-hour excursion to transfer a failed pump module to its external stowage platform and to install an assembly that provides reliable power to the system that moves the station's robotic arm between work sites. Wiseman and Wilmore will conduct a second spacewalk later this month on October 15. And this week, the station was outfitted with a new science instrument that will help keep an eye on the weather. The station's robotic arm was used to remove the ISS Rapid Scatterometer, or RapidScat, from the external trunk of SpaceX's Dragon cargo ship on Tuesday. The hardware was attached to the outside of the Columbus module and will use the station's unique vantage point to better forecast weather and monitor severe storms. And this week's social media question asks how RapidScat actually works. Well, as the station's first ever rotating radar, RapidScat will use pulses reflected from the ocean's surface from different angles to calculate surface wind speed and direction, gathering more complex data for a more accurate survey of Earth's atmosphere. Keep your questions and comments coming using the hashtag Space2Ground, and make sure to follow the ISS on Twitter at space_station. And for a little bit of fun before we go, we've always heard that everyone puts their pants on one leg at a time, right? Well, astronaut Reid Wiseman proves that's not always the case. We'll see you next week.
Ta-da! Zipper!